it's remote. I mean, you see, you've got 2 or 3 miles from one bird to here, so it's impractical on the walk. In bad weather, they need transport.
About 30 nationalities were in the centre last month. A centre like this is very important for them, that they can come ashore into a safe environment. So we're here to support them, to be with them, to hear their stories.
First of all, we go and collect them from the ship and then bring them into here. And then we ask them if there's anything they need, usually phone cards or anything like that. And then if they need to speak to any of the managers or the chaplain, we can organise that. Also, we serve them with the sweets, the drinks, and anything they need. These guys are away 8 to 10 months away from home. They're in an enclosed environment on the ship, so after 10 months on that one ship, they want to be out speaking to different people.
First name? Stephanie. Mm-hmm. There's IT equipment around, there's Wi-Fi. They can phone home, they can Skype, they can see pictures of their loved ones, they can just, in a sense, virtually be home and talk to those families.
Oh, yeah. This is my wife.
That's your wife, is it? Yeah. And that's your boy?
Yes, this boy.
How many weeks since you saw your child?
3 months.
3 months? Mm.
It's
long time.
Very long time.
O God, our Father, we come to you with all our thoughts of the next voyage. On this beautiful day, we remember that sometimes the seas are rough and the journey is hard. And however rough the seas or smooth, we know that far away, these seafarers' families are on the other side of the world.